New York Avenue's history.
Yeah, you can't make it work.
Control into every practice and every shift. He played for the Crest on the front of his jersey. Electrifying his teammates, fans, and Long Island. His pretty never snake eyes style of play made him one of the hardest working players the NHL has ever seen. And he was the first New York Islander to ever wear number 27. Excelling in basketball and baseball. In fact, at the age of 15, he pitched a perfect game. But his love of hockey is what would drive him. In the fall, his father would dam up a culvert next to their home, and then as winter approached and the close over, he would skate hours on end, often alone, always challenging himself to be better, and to realize his dream of playing in the NHL. Playing in the National Hockey League, he did. He played for 14 seasons. During his 8 seasons on Long Island, he played 594 games, recorded 206 goals, 338 assists, for 544 points. Yeah!
Yeah! His tenacity, his spirit, his will to go out there and do whatever he wants. He deserves being a rapper.
John Tonelli! John Tonelli! John Tonelli! my phone away then, right? Because I don't want to hear it.
Making us all feel important to be proud of our roles for knocking us down when we were too cocky, and for picking us up when we were down. Woo! To this day, when I'm confronted by a difficult situation, I always ask myself, how would Al handle it? Al's calm demeanor and his guidance was all that you could ask for in a mentor. I'd also be remiss if I didn't thank Al's wife, Claire, who was also vital to our team's success as well. I would like to also thank several very special people in my life and career. My first agent, Gus Medallion, was responsible for me signing my first contract with the Houston Aeros in the WHA, where I was lucky enough to play alongside Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe. Woo! I'd also like to thank Jim Demolano, who I met through Gus, and Jim believed in me, and in turn convinced the architect of it all, Bill Torrey, to draft me. Woo!
Jim, I hope you're
doing well. I can't thank you enough for backing me and for everything you did for our team. Thanks to my youth and junior hockey coaches, parents on my teams, and all of those in my hometown in Milton, who were all incredibly impactful on my earliest hockey days. They instilled the importance of volunteerism, intensity, discipline, making a difference for others, and not fearing to fail. My gratitude is endless to Coach Collins, Coach Dance, Coach Brown, and the legendary Maple Leaf, George Armstrong, captain of the 67 Stanley Cup champion, who one day knocked on my front door in 1974 and asked my parents if they would allow me to leave home and play for the Toronto Junior Marlies. We said yes, and the rest was history. Tonight is also about Larry Lund, who I thank not only for being a great veteran teammate back in my WJ days, but most of all for being a great mentor and a major influence for an 18-year-old by relating how important it was to prepare for a working life after hockey. I listen, Larry, I can't thank you enough. I was also very fortunate to be coached in Houston by the legendary Bill Benigni, who was a strong, positive force towards my development. Tonight is about thanking my center ice and my right winger, namely Wayne Merrick, and of course, Bobby Duncan. I love you guys, and I would not be standing here without your efforts. Bob, that magical moment on May 24th, 1980. I also played with the spark for our team, namely my friend Butch Goring. Prior to his arrival, we were a pretty good hockey team, but we were missing something. Another big thanks to Bill Torrey, the architect, for finding that piece that we needed. Butch, you were an inspiration to play with, and I am truly looking forward to standing in Iceland next Saturday and watching this tremendous honor. So to be standing here at Nassau Coliseum, where it all happened.
Where it all happened. It all happened here.
Yep. It is especially fitting that as I stand here under Billy Joel's banner, what comes to mind is his song, Matter of Trust. Because when it comes to today's Islanders, trust is exactly what I have in Stanley Cup winners. Boom Lamorello and Barry Trout. Came out with the puck and made great play after great play. It has been wonderful and exciting watching you grow as a player and now as our leader. I am so proud and so honored that you will continue to wear our number. Since I retired from hockey in 92, I have met so many wonderful people. And thankfully, many of you are also here tonight. My family and I are so grateful for your friendship and support. Please know that you're not only my friends, but my extended family as well. I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge two of my great pals who are no longer with us, namely my longtime agent, Bob Thornton, and my best friend, Dick McKenna. I know you guys are watching, and I am thrilled that your families are here tonight to help us celebrate. My mom Joy is here tonight. Woo!
Woo! Oh, that was great.
She's 89 and still. She's 89 and still makes a meatball that ranks up there at the festival. Mom, thank you so much for everything. You know, Dad is watching and smiling away. Thanks to you and Dad for all the sacrifices that you made to get here. Woo! I also would like to thank my brothers Ray and David and my sister Sandra, and for all you've been on my behalf. And of course, I want to thank my best friend, my partner, and my rock, and simply put, the best thing that has ever happened to me, my beautiful wife, Lauren.
Thank you.
take your place in the Raptors as one of the greatest players to ever play for the New York Raptors.
Melton.